That?
We are met tonight in the house of our friend, this most excellent hobbit. May the hair on his toes never fall out.
Hear, hear!
We shall soon start on our long journey. Our object is, I take it, well known to us? All of us?
It is not well known to me.
Really? Then we must inform our burglar. We seek a treasure, that which is rightfully ours. Far off in the east, beyond the misty mountains and the dark forest of Mirkwood, there you will find Lonely Mountain. Long ago, this was the home of my people, and was ruled by my grandfather, King Under the Mountain.
The dwarves of yore made mighty spells, while hammers fell like ringing bells, in places deep where dark things sleep, in hollow halls beneath the fells. Goblets they carved there for themselves, and harps of gold where no man delves. There lay they long, and many a song was sung unheard by man or elves. For ancient king and elvish lord, there many a gleaming golden hoard they shaped and wrought, and light they caught to hide in gems on hilt of sword. On silver necklaces they strung, the flowering stars on crowns they hung, the dragon fire in twisted wire, they meshed the light of moon and sun.
Undoubtedly, all this wealth was what brought the dragon.
The pines were roaring on the height, the winds were moaning in the night, the fire was red, and flaming spread. The trees, like torches, blazed with light.
And below us in the valley lay day, a town of mortal men.
The bells were ringing in the day. The men looked up with faces pale. The dragon's ire, more fierce than fire, laid low their towers and houses frail. The mountains smoked beneath the moon. The dwarves, they heard the tramp of doom. They fled their hall to dying fall, beneath his feet, beneath the moon.
We must away ere break of day, to win our hearts and gold from him.
Curses to the dragon! Curses to Smaug! He killed our men and stole our gold.
Curses to the dragon Smaug!